Hi everyone. So Bard, which is Google's AI tool, has launched some new features to it, and I just want to compare it with ChatGPT's features, because these new features launched by Google Bard just takes it to the next level, seriously. And I just want to let you know about these new features, what Google has introduced in this. Hope at the end of this video you will be able to understand why I say this new features are going to take Bard to the next level. So first, to begin with, I'll just go with the essay at first. Essay on global warming earth something. And I even asked the exact same question to ChatGPT, essay on global warming. So we are just getting a response over here in ChatGPT. That's it, pretty much 5 paras, and we are just getting a conclusion. And we also have a copy link. So, and just like and dislike button, and this is the normal ChatGPT version. I'm not using ChatGPT Plus. So here you can see, right, this is the things that I get for this particular topic. And as I showed you earlier, in ChatGPT we just have these 3 options. None of the options to customize it. We can just click on this regenerate response. That's it, right? But in Google Bard, first thing is, here we are having a regenerate draft, which is exactly similar to ChatGPT's regenerate response, but with that we are having here a listen feature. So this basically reads our text that we got as a response. So if I just now click on this,
here is an essay on global warming. Global warming, a threat to our planet. Global warming is the long-term heating of.
So it basically just reads our response. So in case if you are working on some other thing side by, and if you aren't able to view the screen, you can just click on that and, you know, make Google Bard read for you. So this is super handy. And another cool feature that I found here is that if you just scroll down to the end, you can just click on Google. I think it's already there. But along with this, here you're having a modify response thing. If you click that, here you'll be having 5 options. So show it as shorter, longer, simpler, more casual, and more professional. I'll go with more professional. So what response? So it basically regenerates another response over the same one. So this is what I get for a professional one. So it looks similar, but surely it must have changed some text or context over here. And you also have option to view other drafts also. And the next one is going to be, here you can see, right, this is the game changing feature. I would say we have a upload file option, whereas in ChatGPT in the free version we don't have. I think it is available in the paid version, but we have a upload feature in a free version of Google Bard. So here you can do everything. This basically changes the game for Google Bard. So I'll just show you a couple of demos how this upload feature is taking this to next level. I'll just go here and just click it, and I'll just go with the city. I have this image of a city. Not a city, this is Eiffel Tower. So for those who don't know, it's in Paris, France. So I'm just going to ask, can you name the city? That's it, from this image. Yeah, so basically it needs to process this thing, and it's need to give me the result as it's in Paris, France. So you get it right. The city in the image you sent is Paris, France, and it also gives me a description about Eiffel Tower. You know, can you do this with ChatGPT in the free version? So yeah, this is what exactly I was saying. And using this upload feature, we can now solve complex mathematical problems also, just through an image search. So exactly similar to Google Lens, but we get the help of AI also. So I'll just go to this upload again, and here I'm having a mathematical problem, all right? So I'll just click on open. So this problem is basically this image that I have over here. Solve x minus 1 the whole square equal to 4 root of x minus 4. It's going to be so hard for us to type this problem in words. How can you represent square root of and this whole power and stuff? So it's going to be like a nightmare for us to type this entire thing out. But if you have a screenshot of this problem, you can just upload it to Google Bard, and you can just type solve it, man. That's it. I'm just clicking on submit. Yeah, so here you can see, right, the exact same problem that I have over here. And the solution for this problem is going to be x is equal to 13 and x is equal to 5. So this is the solution. And here you can see, right, within few seconds, the possible values of x are 5 and 13. the exact same answer that we are having here, and it has taken the source from Quora. So basically it has done the job for us, and I'm pretty sure that it will also work in case if that problem is not available in the net also. And another thing is the voice feature. I don't know if this is new or already there, but this is also so useful, makes it so better than ChatGPT. Yeah, see the accuracy here. Yeah, so these are the things that I found out amazing and amusing in Google Bard, and I think ChatGPT nearly needs to innovate their UI. Seriously, like, I think they have some of these features in their paid version, but Google Bard has just got it and given us for free. So yeah, so now it's your turn. Just let me know in the comment section which is best, and after this updates, do you still find Google Bard like better than ChatGPT or something? But the response will change, right? In case if it's a summary or something, the response is gonna change, but these new features have been a really game changer for Google Bard. So that's I wanted to tell you through this video, guys, and check out my playlist. I've done many programming tutorials. Thank you for watching.